In what ways can we better help your families face the added stress of having cancer?
I think offering help but not forcing it if they don't need what you're offering, but definitely offering, providing a listening ear, especially for all the different family members, and praying for them, giving them prayers that you have.
I think this is kind of small, but when you have someone that's sick, it's actually huge as transportation, getting to and from the hospital, or, and I think a big thing is, making them feel when they're away from their family. A lot of times when I was away from my sister, I wanted to feel like a normal kid, and, I think that's important for, the community and for your friends to, make you feel, just like everybody else, and just to have fun, and, yeah.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. I would always look for the moments where I could just lose myself laughing with my friends, or just feel normalcy. As far as my family, I think it was really helpful for them to hear about prayer vigils happening for Emilee, and our whole church started to meet and just gathered around our family. They made dinners. I had people come to my volleyball games since my parents were away the whole 3 months with my sister in the hospital. I also I stayed with the Millers for a couple weeks. I think my whole church family and a lot of Christopher Talk family just gathered around us and helped with transportation and meals, and I think it's little things like that that really help.
This question kind of is the last one, but how can we better support the siblings in these families?
I think that it was my sister, so when you have a sibling, it's your family and it's also your best friend. And you have some of your best moments with them. And it's hard because it's two different parts of your life are being affected. And there was not really much people could say, to make it better. And that was expected. That wasn't anyone's fault. But, I think a big thing, you said, is listening. Because when people that have cancer or have someone close to them who's been affected by cancer come to talk to you about something, that means, they want to talk. Because, we don't go to, I don't go to many people about it. And so, just, opening up and just, trying to, understand. And it's not easy at all, obviously, but
I would say, I definitely agree with. I usually didn't look for opportunities to tell people about what was going on. It wasn't natural for me. So when I had people come up and be like, "Hey, why don't you go grab a Starbucks or let's just why don't you come over for dinner or something?" I don't know. Then I would have an opportunity to open up to someone, which was nice, because I know, I may not always want to talk about it, but when I did talk about it, I think it helped me deal with some of the emotions that I didn't want to face. And I definitely, I think I had some people from my church, come to my volleyball games, and that was, really nice of them, and they were cheering me on. And I think for siblings, you're totally right with the fact that we're losing a family member and we're losing our best friend. So I think anything to kind of not replace, obviously, the sister, but to be there for them as though you were their best friend, just talking or hanging out. It was really helpful for me when I had plans on the weekends with friends. I look forward to those.
When you're going through treatment, what do you miss from your friends? And what do you miss from your school and your teams?
For me, it was basically just to be treated like I wasn't going through treatment. Just treat me as if I wasn't sick or anything. Ask me to do things. Don't shy away from it. And just be honest with me about things. Just tell me, look, you want to hang out, you want to do this. don't shy away from things, like talking wise, question wise, because it just makes it worse when the person.
Yeah, feeling a sense of things being normal was really helpful. And yeah, like you said, when people not shy away from talking to you or looking at you is sort of like funny or not going to, you know, approach you in a certain way. So yeah, keeping things sort of normal.
Genuinely want to hear your answer. So I think it was really needed.